This past session, you introduced legislation to provide for personal finance scores for students in grades 6 through 8. Will this remain a priority for you, or are there other priorities that you'll introduce in the next session?
Well, this is going to be a priority of mine until the day I die, really. It's been my life of people having financial awareness and financial literacy. And that's why we're in trouble a lot of times in most aspects of government, aspects of your personal life, that, you know, I was taught, my brothers and sisters and I, we were taught as young as 7, 8 years old about finances, the importance of money, the importance of saving, the importance of investing. And that's true today. You know, you can take most people in the room and you can look in your past and say, you know, I wish someone would talk to me more about money at a younger age. We see that there are elective opportunities in high school for personal finance classes and things like that. But I would like to see mandatory classes, especially when you're coming up in high school, college. I want to see mandatory personal finance classes teaching people things about income, expense, liabilities, you know, profit, loss, all these things that most people in the financial, you know, professions, you understand those things because that's what you do. But on an everyday, you can't just assume that everybody knows about finance, because guess what? They don't. We wouldn't be in the situation right now and today, because if you have government officials that haven't been taught about finances coming up all the way through their life, how do you think they're gonna actually do a balanced budget at the federal level? They can't, because they haven't been taught. It's almost a blind leading the blind. But I'm 100% in favor of we get them in school at a young age, teaching these kids. Then when you get in high school, let's make it mandatory. And a lot of you that went to college, as soon as you hit the college, they had those credit cards out there waiting on you, and you were signing up, and all those student loans and all these things, and some of you probably been working in your profession 30 years, and you still have a student loan that you haven't been able to pay off yet. Because you got your family, you got all these things that you're trying to do in life, and if you don't have the financial wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, guess what? You're gonna be really in a bad shape your whole life. And if you weren't taught to do better your finances, and now you have kids that came under you, guess what? They're gonna be in the same situation. But I'm blessed that my parents saw the insight and say, look, they're more entrepreneurs, so we had to understand we had to make our money work a little bit better, because that's all we had, what we could take and invest and make it come back to us. And we had to save money at a young age. Every month, we lined up at CNS Bank, years ago, y'all know it, the overpass. We lined up that little green book, and we was in line. Each one of us had to go over that counter and put some money in the bank. We didn't get allowance. I mean, you worked in my family. You had little things that you did around the house. Those things, you don't get allowance for your responsibilities. But all this stuff came in handy for us to go ahead, make money, understand money. And we were always taught that if you can find out what people need and what they want, you always honestly make money. But the greater thing that we was taught is that you have two hands, one to receive with and one to give with. But guess what? If you don't know how to manage your money, if you don't know how to do what you need with money, you won't even have any money to give. You have to use every dime that you have just to try to make ends meet. And I think when I look at education, if you can't really educate people on finances when you're in a capitalistic world, you let every individual on the face of this earth down when you can't help them to teach them. And I'm trying to understand this. Listen to what I'm saying. If you work, we're teaching you how to go to a profession. We're teaching you how to get a job. We teach you how to get a better education so you can make money. But what point is it for us to educate you and spend 58% of our state budget on educating you to get a job to make money when you're not going to know what to do with the money? So I'm going to leave it right there, because I can go on for like 10 hours, you know, on finances and what I'm talking about, how, you know, how frustrated I get to see the poor get poor and stay poor. Because so many things we have going on economically where people don't know the basics. And when you don't know the basics, you got to stay in poverty. So I believe that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Representative.